Joining me right now, Dr. Linda Nabha. We've got breaking news, and we tried to get it into you earlier, and that's where we were stumbling. We've got confirmed cases right now as we speak in the state of Maryland. The governor has scheduled an 8 o'clock press conference. You knew this was coming.
I knew this was coming. This was no surprise. We were waiting for this. We have testing now at the Department of Health in Maryland. Those tests were confirmed at the Department of Health in Maryland, and we knew it was coming.
We don't have a lot of details at this point, but if we've got, just based on your experience, we've got three confirmed cases, and we don't know if they're at the same place or if they're three separate cases at this point, but what does that really mean? That means it's bigger than three at this point, probably.
We know that if they've tested positive, meaning they probably presented with symptoms, meaning that they may have had the infection for up to 14 days. So we know that it's at least been circulating in Maryland for some period of time.
And that says to me all the people they've come in contact, beginning with immediate family, then if they work, if they go to classes, whatever, there are other people potentially exposed also.
Exactly. Remember, Bruce, this is a respiratory droplet infection. So anyone that they may have coughed on, they may have sneezed on, anyone that's touched the respiratory droplets is at risk.
And again, let's say right now, what are the symptoms? What should people be looking for?
So symptoms that we know of are nonspecific. What we do know from China and the symptoms from China is that people present with flu-like symptoms. Most commonly, those who have detected virus, those who've tested positive for a virus, majority of them have a fever, have a cough, shortness of breath, myalgias or muscle aches and pains. And then there are some cases of diarrhea or gastrointestinal problems.
Yeah, I think we heard from the vice president today. I think he says that we don't have enough kits to meet the demand at this point. What does that say to you?
It's a little concerning. I mean, we are operating on the idea that we need to test these people and find out who's positive and then go from there. So if we don't have the testing, then we can't treat and evaluate those people and those that they've come in contact with.
And who's tested? Just the people who display the symptoms, or is there an at-risk population that ought to be tested immediately?
Sure. So there's no surveillance testing at this point. Right now, the criteria is if someone comes in with respiratory infection plus a fever, and they've either traveled to particular countries or they've been exposed to a population where there is community spread at this point, or right now, just today, the guidelines have been updated that if someone has been in a nursing facility or at a hospital and they're presenting with these symptoms, then they should get tested.
You know, some people are asking the question right now, they're getting information that they will all have some form, show some symptoms, if only a mild version of the coronavirus. Any truth to that?
So we do believe that people have had a very mild form, so mild that they didn't necessarily have to present to a hospital or a physician. In fact, there have been documented cases in China of people who haven't had any symptoms who've tested positive for the virus.
Okay, don't go anywhere.